So according to MLB.com, there's a 30-second timer between batters. Mm-hmm. So the batters have 30 seconds to get into the batter's box. Between pitches, there's a 15-second timer that'll be in place. And a 20-second timer with runners on scoring on the
base.
Runners on base. The other little hitch is that the batter must be in ready position no later than the 8-second mark. If they're not, then the batter is actually charged with a strike. That was the thing that I watch baseball. My dad loves baseball. I'm a Cardinal fan. However, hey, Sadie Brown.
It's babies and mamas.
Terry Lynn.
Hey, Terry.
Yeah, we recording too.
You're live on stage.
You're live on TV. Terry Lynn, say hi.
TV?
Yeah, say hi. All our fans wish want to tell you, hey, Terry Lynn.
I know they do. Y'all got two, three.
The two that's in here right now. And it'll be down to one when one leaves.
Uh-huh. So anyway, our brother Bo is the reason why I'm not as big a baseball fan as I could be, because Bo made me quit baseball with one below. Let's just say that.
He made me quit first. He hit me in the nose with a hard ball.
Hey, mine was a little lower than the nose, bro. Little lower than the nose. And I quit from then on. Took the glove off. I quit. So
I hid my glove up under the stove in the basement.
There you go. There you go. Just watching baseball, the pace of the game has gotten a lot longer the last few years because the reason that they're changing putting the pitch clock in is because of the runners get on first base or whatever, get on base, and then the pitcher throws over there 12 times before he makes a pitch. And then he throws over another 10 times before he make a pitch. The pitch clock to me is a good idea. But the little caveat with the 8-second thing, I really like that because now batters can't wait to the last second to jump in the batter's box and knowing the pitcher only got 20 seconds to throw a pitch. So I thought that was a pretty good twist to it.
Right. Yeah, I'm interested to see how it's really going to impact the game. Particularly, like I said, I already think it's going to shorten the game, but I think it's going to be interesting to see if it'll really impact scoring because of that rule. Because again, now you know when you really have a timer on the pitcher, where at first you had to guess. Now you really have a timer and you have to, make sure, so I think it's going to, hopefully we'll see a lot more stolen bases.
Mm-hmm. And the pitcher's going to get, batter's going to get better pitches because the pitcher's going to be rushing. They have their little routine. So they're going to look up the clock, say, oh, I got 5 seconds. Let me get ready to throw this ball. Mm-hmm. So they're going to be rushing and not throwing the pitches that they wanted to throw.
Right.
So, but that's a pretty cool thing. We're gonna like I said, see how it works. Because baseball games, a 3.5 hour baseball game is really too long.
Yeah,
there's not enough excitement in the baseball game.
Old sleepy guys.
Exactly. For old folks. So anyway.
Fellas, y'all know I've been upset. I got a gripe to pick. And it's with your boy, Aaron Rodgers. Now y'all know, let's talk about it. If Aaron Rodgers just wanted the money, he would already signed with the Jets. And he hasn't. Aaron's legacy is in the balance here. So if he truly wants a shot at appearing in or even winning another Super Bowl, he has to sit down with the Green Bay Brass to restructure that $58 million option bonus. This will allow other teams to come at you for a potential trade. What you're doing to the Jets and the Green Bay is basically teetering on the lines of extortion. Aaron, I'm talking to you. You have just as many rings as these guys. Trent Dilfer, Joe Flacco, and Nick Foles. Not to mention, Russell Wilson and Patrick Mahomes have been to more Super Bowls than you. So let that sink in for a minute, Aaron. Aaron, the opportunity for you to get back to the Super Bowl within the next 2 years is with one team, your childhood team, the San Francisco 49ers. John Lynch, you have 11 compensatory draft picks in your back pocket. Pull off some of that same magic you used to get Christian McCaffrey and give Green Bay all that shit, along with Sam Darnold's bust ass too. Aaron, back to you. Come join what will be your future Hall of Fame brother, my guy, Joe Montana and Steve Young. Aaron, you've never beat us. Come join us. And if not, fuck you then, punk. We'll take Lamar. So ladies and gentlemen, come this Saturday, I'm expecting breaking news during the NCAA tournament that one of those outstanding quarterbacks will be a 49.
For the block, boy. Take it rough.
Once again, people, we want to thank you for joining us in our podcast. We just four guys, three tonight, that's from the East Saint, just having fun talking about sports.
That's what we do.
For Dorian, for Deuce, for Dante, I'm Rodney. And we want to leave you all with our famous saying.
Oh, kiss it.
And we out. Thank you. Goodbye.
Say bye, Chickadee.
Turn around. Say bye.
Say bye, Chickadee.
Santa Brown. Oh, she's
drinking a thirst cup.
Say bye, bye.
We got to get a whole lot more likes because you on here.
All right.
Holla.
For the block, boy. Take it rough.
Don't blame it on the sunshine. Don't blame it on the moonlight. Don't blame it on the good times. Blame it on the boogie. Don't blame it on the sunshine. Don't blame it on the moonlight. Don't blame it on the good times.
I made you look. You a slave to a page in my rhyme book. They shootin'. I made you look. You a slave to a page in my rhyme book.